Are you looking for a better way to connect with your customers? Well, provide them a tool where they can provide feedback, report bugs with screenshots, video recordings, and a way for them to contact you. All of this can be done with this tool. Plus, you can install this on any website that you want. WordPress site, PHP sites, mobile applications, and get all that information. But on top of all that information that you're going to capture, this is going to be stored on this application where you are going to later work with your developers and have everything really well managed and squash those bugs right away. Now, this is really cool and it's super easy to implement. So let's get started with this video and show you what I'm talking about right now. What's up everyone, my name is George and this is SaaS Master. The tool that I'm talking about is called Gleap. This one provides you the widget for your website or mobile application to add that widget where they can provide the feedback. The widget is this one right here. They can report bug issues, they can request features, and they can contact you. Plus you can also create surveys. On top of all of this, you have a platform where you can do a follow-up with your developers. So it's pretty cool. Before I get started, I want to show you a limited time deal that's going on right now. And it's this one right here. It's a lifetime deal. So it's $59 for the lifetime deal. That means that you pay once and you can use it forever. Now, let me show you really quickly what the limits are for that deal so you can understand it. These are licensed tiers. So there's 1, 2, 3, and 4. License tier 1, which is $59 for the lifetime deal, provides you 5 projects, which is 5 sites. 3 months data retention. So all that feedback that you're going to capture and bug reports are gonna be retained for 3 months unless you delete it, right? But if you need more time, I do recommend you jump into another license tier. And all the license tiers remove the Gleap branding. So that's pretty cool. You can put your own logo and your own branding. Now, if you need more sites and more time for data retention, there's license tier 2, which gives you more projects. But the sweet spot and my recommended license is license tier 4 because it's unlimited projects, unlimited data retention, so it doesn't expire, and you get the remove Gleap branding. So if you have a lot of websites and a lot of applications, this would be the way to go. Now, how good is this tool? Well, I like it because it's super easy to use for the end user, and I like how they provide the way to follow up with your developers. Let me show you really quickly this tool, okay? So I've installed it on this WordPress site, which is a classified ads I have site. And I'm in incognito mode, I'm not logged in, this could be potentially anyone, all right? So this is a little widget that's provided. In this case, I haven't removed the branding. So you can see the branding here, but I can replace that, all right? So I can report a bug right now, I can request a feature, or I can contact someone. In this case, I'll report a bug, and I'll make this really easy. I can say, for example, I can't find the category, all right? And I'll put my email, and I have the chance to do a screenshot for the bug or screen recording. So I'll just screenshot this, all right? Let's just say potentially this is something that I want to highlight and I'm gonna say, you know what? The problem is right here, all right? That's where I want to highlight it. I can also do another type of color. I can change these colors. I can undo and I'll go ahead, click a next and it'll add that screenshot there. Go ahead and submit it and I should be getting that. Boom, I just got that issue reported right now, all right? So I can do a follow-up with that. Now, if I have a feature request, also like this one, and again, you have that information to fill out. If I want to contact, super simple widget to add, all right? Now, what do I do with that information? I mean, I got it. What do I do with it? Before I jump into this customization, I want to show you the feedback system. We actually have like a task management system here, which is called open, where I get all the feedback, in progress, to do, and done. So you can invite your team members or your developers to be inside of this platform. So as soon as you get a bug report, your developers are gonna jump on it because they're gonna view it right here. For example, I can't find the category. That's the one I made right now. You get a ton of information. So for example, we got the screenshot, okay. So what is this person trying to tell me? Okay, so something has to do with the category, all right? So I'm viewing the screenshot or the video if they provide it, all right? So I can reply by email, I can write notes, I have the information, who is it assigned to, so I can assign it to a specific developer. You know, if it has to do with sales, if it has to do with development, if it has to do with hosting, etc., I'll send it to the right person. Priority, right now it's medium, but it might be high because it's super important. The status right now, it's open. What type is it? It's a bug, but it could be a crash report, inquiry, or feature request. I can add tags to this so I can later find it really easily. Who filled it out. So in this case, it was a guest, the user ID, it's not set. But if I log in to that WordPress site with my user for the classified ads system, it'll add my name and the system and the information for it. I can archive it, send it to an integration, so I can integrate with another application if I want to send it to ClickUp, to Asana, to something else. Mark as duplicate, so you don't want duplicates. On top of all of that, you get session data. So what browser was this person using? What are they using? Netscape, the session duration, the screen width. So for example, if they say, you know what, I can't view the login button, for example. Okay, it might have to do with screen width. So we get that information. The URL that was used, the SDK, the system, the device pixels, all that information. Activity log. So what happened during that session? Where did they click? Where did they go? What sites? Was there errors during this system? No errors were found. Warnings, none of them. Logs, clicks, I can remove and filter out all of these and view them. So all that information is there. So if there's an error there because they're using an ad blocker, for example, hey, that could be the issue. And it's super easy to tell the user, you know what? Disable your ad blocker for this website and everything will be fine. Custom data, if we want to add it there, and replay in case there are video recordings. You get all that information. And you can have your developers work on this really easily. So if you found this and they're working on it, well, it's in progress. It's now, let's go ahead and test it if everything's fine. Let's go ahead and tell the user via email, or it's done. Boom, we've solved that bug and we squashed it really easily, all right? There's also the inquiries. For example, I need more help. That's a contact system. And again, we have all the information available for that, the station data, the custom data available. The features request, so let's go ahead and check this out. The feature request is right here. Again, we view all the information, subscriber, data station, custom data. And again, if we feel it's a good idea, it's been under review, well, it's good. Let's go ahead and plan it. And if it's already in plan for a while and you're ready to develop, well, let's bring it to in progress, all right? You can add a board to this. You can archive and spam and the dashboard, all of that. You get the analytics for this, the custom experience. In this case, we can create surveys also. So for example, if I want to create a survey for this website for something like product market fit, we'll go ahead and click that. I can provide a feedback. So that means that when they go into the website, boom, this widget is going to pop up. And I can add questions, remove questions, edit questions, and so on and so forth. Options, collect email addresses of users, or you just want the feedback. Maybe you don't want to ask them email because they won't provide the feedback. It just depends on you. Single page form, show all questions on all pages or particular pages, privacy policy, and the audience. Fixed, dynamic, all people, users only, or guest only. Boom, launch it, and you have that survey going super easily. You have the sessions available here for the users who have used the widget. Now let's go into configuration. So right here, like I mentioned before, in the deal that's available for a limited time, you have the option to customize the logos and all of that. For example, the welcome message, we can change that. Hide after greeting, hide name. So for example, if they are logged in, we'll view the name right here. We can change the colors because maybe it doesn't have to do with our branding. In my case, for example, the classified ad site is red. So maybe I want to change it to red. Add logos. The corner radius, the UI colors, the backgrounds, the branding, if I want to remove it, the button color, different positions, places. For example, this is a little bit more useful in case you already have some chat widget. You just want to get this for the bug reporting that's available. Okay, the integrations that you can integrate with. So you have all of these options available. There we go. You have webhooks and Zapier. I mean, if the integration is not available here, you can do so with these integrations. So super easily. And last but not least, we have the settings for the integration and the installation. For WordPress, all you have to do is install the plugin if you don't want to install the code. In that plugin, it'll ask you for the API key and you're good to go. I mean, it's set and you start editing right here on Gleap. So all of that is super easy to implement with this system. So like I mentioned before, if you want to have an easy way for your customers to connect with you and do a follow-up with your developers, this is the tool to go. Plus, with that special pricing that's going on right now, you don't want to miss out on it. That unlimited deal is pretty good, all right? Well, if you guys want to grab the deal, there will be a link in the description that's an affiliate link. So if you buy through that link, it helps me out with a small commission and it's not going to cost you a single cent more than what it already says there. And if you are a new customer, you will get a 10% discount when buying this deal. So take advantage of that. I thank you all for watching, and I'll see you on my next videos.